Hi, my name is Paul Offit. I'm talking to you today from the Vaccine Education Center here at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. One thing that parents worry about or wonder about is, do I really need a vaccine if I've already had one or two doses? Do I really need to finish out the schedule, for example? Or maybe I've already been exposed to a virus or bacteria, so I don't really need to even get vaccines at all. And so instead, how about if I just have my blood tested to see whether or not I have a protective immune response already against that particular virus or bacteria? It's not as easily done as you would think. So for example, for some pathogens like the bacterium Haemophilus influenzae type B or the virus hepatitis B, if you have a certain quantity of antibodies in your blood, you can virtually be guaranteed that you will not get that disease if you're exposed to that bacteria or virus. For those two, it's clear. For some, it's less clear. So, for example, if you have antibodies directed against measles virus that are of a certain titer, you can be pretty much assured that you are not going to get measles then if you're exposed to the natural or wild-type virus. However, there was an outbreak of measles in the late 1980s, early 1990s that swept through the United States. It caused more than 50,000 hospitalizations and caused about 120 children, mostly, to die for measles. When people looked back at that outbreak, you found that there were many people who had been vaccinated, but who didn't have antibodies against measles, who were still protected. And the reason they were protected is they had something called memory cells, memory immunological cells like B and T cells, which then, when they were exposed to the virus, became activated, differentiated, made antibodies, which then protected them. So even though they didn't have circulating antibodies in their bloodstream, they still had these memory cells in their immune system that could then respond when they were exposed. So if you looked at those people and saw that they didn't have antibodies, you would have falsely concluded they weren't protected when they were. Sometimes you can have antibodies in your bloodstream and not be protected. So, for example, rotavirus or pertussis bacteria affect really just the mucosal surfaces. So rotaviruses just infect the lining of the small intestine. Pertussis or whooping cough infects the sort of the lining of the trachea, the windpipe, and the lungs. But it doesn't really, that virus and the bacteria don't really spread into the bloodstream and cause a systemic infection. They're so-called mucosal infections. So when you look at immunity in the bloodstream, that doesn't necessarily predict whether or not there's going to be adequate immunity at that mucosal surface. The point being that titers are difficult, that they're not a cure-all, they're not a perfect predictor, and so I think your best way of knowing that you're protected is to get the vaccines that are recommended at the time that they're recommended. Thank you.